Let us start learning about silicate mineralogy. From the physical property presentations, you might have realized that the nearly 4,500 existing mineral species have various properties, appearances, and other trivialities. In order to effectively study them, it is crucial to organize them in a meaningful classification. So let's explore the classification of minerals based on the anion or anionic complexes. This classification was started by Zoltai and Stott in 1984 and is now prevalent everywhere. What's neat about this classification is that we can determine classes from the chemical formula only. Also, within each class, the structure and bonding is nearly the same, and it is due to this reason only we have not divided minerals based on the cations, because cations do not determine the properties of minerals to the extent of anions. For example, pyrite Fe2S and ferrite Fe2SiO4 have the same cation but have few properties common in them. Also, the minerals of these classes do not occur at the same abundance. Even when the earth is a big and dynamic system, the crust is nearly 3/4 silicon and oxygen. Just these two elements make up a prominent part of the crust, and hence it is not surprising that their mineral is the most abundant. So we'll focus on silicates only for the rest of the series of videos. Silicon does not occur in the free state, and silica or SiO2 is the only oxide of silicon which exists in nature. This silica can be found in the form of quartz, chalcedony, flint and agate, where quartz is the most common rock forming mineral, and all those large number of minerals containing silicon are known as silicate minerals. The fundamental unit or the building blocks of all silicate minerals is SiO4 tetrahedron. Since those oxygen atoms have to maximize the distance between them in order to be stable, those oxygen atoms occupy positions of the corners of a tetrahedron, which maximizes the angle between all the atoms to 109.5 degrees. Now, why silicon is surrounded by 4 oxygen atoms only? This is determined by the coordination number, which is the minimum radius ratio of the cation and anion. For SiO4, this radius ratio between silica and oxygen comes out to be 0.225, and that corresponds to 4 coordination number. This determines that one silica will be surrounded by 4 oxygen atoms only. These silicon tetrahedrons can also join together to form various types of silicate minerals, which we will see later. But almost always, the tetrahedrons only share a corner, because this maximizes the distance between the silicon cations at the center. Tetrahedrons sharing an edge are very uncommon. The cation to cation distance in this case is reduced to nearly half as it was previously, causing intercationic repulsion, which severely distorts the tetrahedron. Finally, tetrahedrons sharing a face is never found when both of the tetrahedrons are occupied by silicon, as it makes the structure highly unstable. You may have wondered that all the atoms in SiO4 tetrahedron will not be having a stable octet. To resolve this, other elements may also be accommodated within the silicate framework so as to neutralize the minus 4 charge in the tetrahedron. Coming over to the classification of silicate structures, it is important to know the basis of classification. The classification of silicate structures is based upon the different ways the silicon tetrahedrons are grouped. This results in a silicate mineral being either a mesosilicate, sarosilicate, cyclosilicate, inosilicate, phyllosilicate or tectosilicate. Different ways of grouping the tetrahedron give rise to different ratios of silicon to oxygen in the silicate mineral, which is shown here. From mesosilicates to tectosilicates, the silicon to oxygen ratio keeps on increasing. We shall now discuss each category in detail. So starting with the mesosilicates, silicate minerals where the SiO4 tetrahedron are isolated and are bound to each other only by ionic bonds from interstitial cations are called mesosilicates. The atomic packing is generally dense, causing high specific gravity and high hardness of such minerals. The crystal habit is generally equidimensional, and there is a lack of any pronounced cleavage in such minerals. One of the examples of mesosilicates is olivine, and it can be observed that the individual tetrahedrons are isolated from each other and are only joined by a magnesium or iron cation. Similar is the case with topaz, since it is also a mesosilicate, but the cations are somewhat more complexly arranged in the interstices. Other examples of mesosilicates include zircon, garnet, andalusite, sillimanite and kyanite. Next, we have the sarosilicates. They have pairs of isolated tetrahedrons. Sarosilicates are formed by sharing of apical oxygen atom between the tetrahedrons. The paired silicon tetrahedra in all sarosilicates result in Si2O7 groups. Lawsonite, a sarosilicate, is a rare mineral found in blueses, a kind of metamorphic rock. In this mineral, Al plus the iron links pairs of silicon tetrahedron. Other minerals like Vesuvianite, also called idocrase, and epidote may contain both SiO4 and Si2O7 groups. Next, we have cyclosilicates. Cyclosilicates are essentially silica tetrahedron that form a closed ring-like structure. Rings of 3, 4, and 6 tetrahedron are known. Tourmaline is the only common mineral which has independent 6 tetrahedron rings. Penitoid is a 3 tetrahedron ring, axinite has 4 of them, and beryl has 6 tetrahedron ring-like structure. Coming over to inosilicates, when the silicon tetrahedrons are linked in a chain, whether singly or doubly, then the mineral is called an inosilicate. Pyroxenes and amphiboles are inosilicates, but pyroxenes consist of single chain, whereas amphiboles are made up of 2 chains. And in fact, this difference also causes them to have different cleavage, which is an important property for identifying pyroxenes and amphiboles apart. Moving on to phyllosilicates, when the tetrahedrons of a silicate mineral repeat in 2 dimensions, giving rise to a sheet-like structure, then the mineral is called a phyllosilicate. Phyllosilicates can be thought of as inosilicates, just with the chain structure extending in 2 directions, resulting in a sheet of tetrahedrons. It can be seen that in this structure of biotite, purple tetrahedrons are arranged in a sheet-like structure. 2 sheets of these tetrahedron layers sandwich a yellow octahedral layer between them, making a TOT layer. These TOT layers are linked to each other with an interlayer cation, which in this case is potassium. This basic sheet structure is seen in all mica minerals. Clay minerals, talc, chlorite, and serpentine are also phyllosilicates. Talc also have TOT layers, but no interlayer cations are present here. Finally, we have tectosilicates. In tectosilicates, all the O2 ions in each SiO4 tetrahedron are shared with a neighboring tetrahedron. This results in a stable, strongly bonded structure with an Si2O ratio of 1:2. This slide shows silicate structures of high albite, a feldspar. It shows three-dimensional network of SiO4 along with systematic arrangement of sodium cation. Approximately 64% of the rocky crust of Earth is made up of minerals which are tectosilicates. These silicate structures control the physical property of minerals, like 6-ring cyclosilicates crystallize in hexagonal crystal system. We already know that decreasing Si2O ratio from tectosilicates to nesosilicates causes corresponding increase in their specific gravities. Also, the structure of inosilicates and phyllosilicates cause them to have pronounced cleavage. Over the next videos on silicate mineralogy, we will be studying the various silicate families, which will be based on the classification we just learned here. There, we'll explore the properties of individual minerals, discuss their occurrences and structures, along with reviewing the most important and common minerals of each family. Thank you.